Hey, what is going on, everybody? It's your boy X coming at y'all with a brand new video. And as you guys can see, we have some new buzzer beater packs with two new Galaxy Opals and four cards total, with a Pink Diamond Brandon Roy and a Klay Thompson, along with Galaxy Opal Patrick Ewing and Jamal Crawford. Now, Jamal Crawford shows up as a shooting guard right here, but if we are to actually go over to the collection right here, go to premium, go over to buzzer beater and actually look him up, he is a shooting guard PG, so you don't have to worry about that at all. Now, we're going to start off with Klay Thompson and go over his stats and just kind of, you know, see what he's all about. I've already done this once. I recorded and realized there was no audio connected. I didn't plug in my mic, so we're doing this for a second time, so hopefully we're good this time. He has a 95 defensive and 94 offensive overall, has a nice 85 dropping layup, a 78 post fade, which is kind of low, also 79 draw foul, really low, but a 96 midi, 98 three-point shot, no real dunking, but an 87 free throw, decent playmaking, nothing too great, but it's not too bad, an 89 steal, 96 perimeter defense, no road rebounding, an 82 speed, 78 speed ball, 82 acceleration, a 95 lateral quickness, has 12 Hall of Fame badges, catch and shoot, corner specialist, volume shooter, tireless shooter, slippery off ball, pick dodger, quick draw, hot dark green machine, flex release, clutch shooter, off ball pest, and 15 nice gold badges, 2 silver and 2 bronzes, has pickpocket, range extender, and clamps on gold, hot zone hunter on gold as well, and some nice ones on bronze and silver. But if you're looking for a budget 2 guard, I think your better option is to go over and grab a Cam Reddish. Still not this Klay Thompson, I feel like it's a better option, but again, that's just personal opinion. Next, we have Galaxy Opal Brandon, Pink Diamond Brandon Roy, and my one thing that I said about this card on Twitter, and I've been saying about the normal Galaxy Opal Brandon Roy, is that they need to update the Opal Brandon Roy's tendencies. So if the Pink Diamond Brandon Roy has better tendencies, it's going to be bad, but thankfully I've gone through and I checked them. They're normal. The dunking tendencies and layup tendencies are normal for, or basically the same for them. They should be 100 standing, driving, and flashy like every other really good dunking card, but they didn't do it for Roy. Doesn't make any sense. Couldn't tell you. But the Pink Diamond has a 96 driving layup, an 84 post fade, a 94 midi, 92 three-point shot, 88 free throw, 95 driving dunk, 75 standing dunk, 88 ball handle with good playmaking, and 85 steal. 89 perimeter defense, a 70 block and interior, on the rebounding, but a 92 speed, a 90 speed ball, 92 acceleration, and 92 lateral quickness. Has 20 all of fame badges compared to the Opal's 21. Volume shooter, catch and shoot, tireless shooter, difficult shots, acrobat, relentless finisher, range center, pickpocket, quick draw, green machine, clamps, dead eye, space creator, quick first step, downhill, pro touch, fast break finisher, tireless defender, consistent finisher, contact finisher, and 21 gold badges that are all really nice, like tight handles, defensive leader, hot zone hunter, pick dodger. And I did want to say, for people wondering, the one extra Hoff badge that the Opal has is Ankle Breaker. I'll show it to you right there. You can see it on the right side with Opal Ankle Breaker. You cannot see it on the left. So that is the one extra badge that he does have, which is kind of cool, but it's not the most important badge, but it's still nice that the Opal is very, very, very slightly better. Next, we have Galaxy Opal Patrick Ewing, who is a 7-foot center, has a 99 offensive and defensive overall, has 41 Hoff badges, which is kind of crazy. Has an 86 dropping layup, a 98 post fade, 97 post hook, 98 midi, an 87 three-point shot, which is actually really, really, really nice, 89 free throw, 98 standing dunk, 90 driving dunk, decent playmaking, and actually 77 ball handle, which is actually really good, 95 steal, 95 block, 84 steal and perimeter defense, and 97 interior defense, 97 in offensive and defensive rebounding, an 87 speed, 81 speed ball, and an 86 acceleration, and an 85 lateral quickness, which for a 7-foot center is really, really good. Like, he's a 7-foot, 240 center, and he can actually move really well. That's like Kareem type speed, which is kind of wild. Like, really kind of nice. Has 41 Hall of Fame badges, brick wall, catch and shoot, corner exposures, difficult shots, pick and popper, quick draw, relentless finisher, post pick technician, drop slipper, put back boss, pump fake maestro, hot zone hunter, lob city finisher, green machine, flex release, rim protector, deep fades, chase on artist, box clamps, defensive leader, heart crusher, interceptor, intimator, moving truck, quick first step, rebound chaser, pogo stick, post move lockdown, tireless defender, trapper, worm, back down punisher, consistent finisher, contact finisher, cross key score, deep hooks, pick and roller, dream shake, pro touch, and downhill. A 7-foot center with downhill and quick first step on Hoff is just crazy. 12 really, really good gold badges like pickpocket, break starter, stuff like that. Really, really nice. And I actually like this Patrick Ewing. I think he's a better version of Taco Fall, but Taco Fall is 5 inches like taller, so maybe he's a little bit better. But I still think the best center that we have right now is low-key Pink Diamond Minute Bowl after picking him up. So, you know, there's that. And next we have Galaxy Opal Jamal Crawford, who can play the PG, as I showed you guys, and that's probably what you should run him at. because he's, you know, 6'5" and has 40 Hoff badges. Has a 98 driving layup, no post game, but a 97 midi, 95 three-point shot, 92 free throw, and 85 driving dunk, which is better than I thought they'd give Jamal Crawford, but that's still really good. A 99 ball handle with great playmaking, a 92 steal, 90 perimeter defense, decent rebounding, and 96 speed ball and acceleration with a 96 lateral quickness as well. And he's low-key looking pretty nice. Has a 40 Hall of Fame badges, volume shooter, catch and shoot, floor general, difficult shots, acrobat, tier dropper, relentless finisher, ankle breaker, tireless shooter, slippery off ball, range extender, and quick draw, dimer, pickpocket, ice in veins, clamps, hot start, hot zone, 100 degree machine, lightning reflexes, flex pro release, pogo stick, tireless defender, dead eye, consistent finisher, contact finisher, clutch shooter, fancy fork, fast break finisher, giant slayer, pro touch, ability finisher, downhill, handles for days, needle that are quick first step, space skater, stop and go, tight handles, unpluckable, and 11 gold badges. They're all actually really nice. Jamal Crawford is going to be breaking ankles and greening in people's faces like it is nothing. He can actually drive to the basket really well. On offense, he's amazing and can still hold his own on defense. I think he's going to be a really, really great card. He's on par with cards like the Opal James Harden or the Opal Zach LaVine. I do think I'm leaning more towards Zach LaVine, but it's not saying that this Jamal Crawford is bad at all. Still a nice card. Let me know if you guys want me to do a gameplay with any of the cards down below. Subscribe if you guys are new on that road to 4.9K. And like the video if you guys did enjoy. Hope you guys have a great rest of your day. And I will see you all in the next video. And I got this soul.